Namaskar children, welcome you all. Today I am going to start with another very important topic of grammar, that is tenses. Tenses help us to express our views and to understand others. But before to understand tenses, it is very important to understand sentences. Let's understand what is sentence. What is sentence? A group of meaningful words arranged in a proper order that makes a complete sense is a sentence. Sentence begins with a capital letter and ends with full stop. Now let's understand the types of sentences. According to tense, there are four types of sentences. First, affirmative or assertive or simple sentence. Let's understand their structure. Subject, helping verb, main verb plus object followed by full stop. So first understand what is the subject. Subject is the doer of the action. Helping verb means supporting verb or auxiliary verb. Main verb, it means the verb, the word which tells you about the action, that is called main verb. And now understand what is object. Object means receiver of the action. Now see the example first. Ram is writing a letter. So in this sentence, Ram is doer of the action. Ram is subject. Is this supporting verb or helping verb? Writing is a main verb. It is telling about the action. Letter is the receiver of the action. So it is the object of the sentence. I hope it is clear to you how to identify subject, helping verb, main verb and object of the sentence. Now let's understand the second type of sentence. It is a negative sentence. The structure of the negative sentence: subject plus helping verb plus not plus main verb plus object. Example: Ram is not writing a letter. Third type of sentence is a interrogative sentence. Interrogative sentence mainly divided into two types. Help. First, those start with helping verb, another start with WH verb. Those start with helping verb, their answer will be in yes or no. Let's understand first interrogative sentence, those start with helping verb. First, their structure: helping verb plus subject plus main verb plus object plus etc. followed by question mark. Now see the example. Is Ram writing a letter? It is asking a question. Is Ram writing a letter? So our answer will be in yes or no. Either yes, Ram is writing a letter, or no, Ram is not writing a letter. Now let's understand second type of interrogative sentence. Those start with WH word. This type of interrogative sentence is not only answerable in yes or no. We need to little bit descriptive. We have to describe our answer. Let's understand the structure first. WH word plus helping verb plus subject plus main verb plus object plus etc. followed by question mark. Now see the example. Why is Ram writing a letter? So what answer we will get? Ram is writing a letter to express his feeling, or Ram is writing a letter to post to his sister. Okay, we will not get answer only in yes or no. We need to be little bit descriptive for writing the answer of this kind of question which start with WH word. Now let's understand the four type of sentences. Interrogative, negative sentence. These type of sentences also divided into mainly two types. As interrogative sentence divided into two types, so interrogative, negative sentence also divided into two types. Let's understand first structure. Helping verb plus subject plus not plus main verb plus object plus etc. followed by question mark. Now see the example. Is Ram not writing a letter? Now understand the second type of interrogative sentence. Now understand the second type of interrogative plus negative sentence. WH word plus helping verb plus subject plus not plus main verb plus object plus etc. Now let's see the example. Why is Ram not writing a letter? You want to know what is WH word. WH word are those words used to ask questions. It is also known as the interrogative question word. For example, why, where, when, whom, which, how. So all these are WH word. Those used to ask a question, and it is also called interrogative question words. I hope now it is clear to you what is WH word. I hope now it is clear to you. These are the basic structure of sentences. Now let's start with tenses. Let's understand what is tenses. When we heard this word, the very first question which comes to our mind is, what is tense? So tense means time. Time of what? Time of verb. It means tense defines time of verb. Then what is verb? Verb means action. So we can say tense defines time of action. So how it defines the time of action? By changing the form of the verbs. If I say I go to school, so this is telling about present action. If I say I went to school, it is telling about past action. If I say I will go to school, it's telling us about future action. So how you will know? So you will come to know about the change of time by changing the form of the verb. It means tenses or tense defines the time of action by changing the form of the verbs. Let's understand this with the help of example. First example which I said, I go to school. Second, I said I went to school. Third, I said I will go to school. So in these all three examples, which word is changing? This. In this sentence, go is used as a base form of the verb or first form of the verb. In this, go became went, and it is called the second form of the verb. And in this, went became go. It is the first form of the verb followed by helping verb. So what is changing in all these sentences? That is the form of the verb. So how you will identify in each sentence what is subject, what is verb, and what is object? So first is subject. Subject means the doer of action. Second is verb. Verb means which is telling about the action. Action done by subject. Now third is called object. Object means the receiver of the action. So who is going to school? Who is going to school? Then we'll get the answer, I. So what I is doing? What action I do? Go. Going to. So where I is going? I is going to school. So action is applied on school. So it will be the receiver of action. That's why it will call object. Which word tell you
about the action in sentence is called verb. That verb forms will change and will give you effect of time, change of time, as you can see the in these examples. First example, verb is go. Now you understood what is verb and how to find the verb. And here we have used the first form of the verb. That's why we can say it is the present. It is telling about the present action. I go to school. In this, as I make you clear how to identify the verb, now you understand that here went. Went is the second form of the verb. Second form of the verb of go. Went. When we use second form of the verb, it is telling about the past action. So it means I went to school is telling about the past action. Now come to the third example. I will go to school. In this we have used the first form of the go followed by helping verb. So it is telling about the future action. Okay, so now you understood how with the help of change in form of verb we can define the change of time. Now let's understand it with the help of definition of tense.
Introduction. The word tense is derived from Latin word tempus, which means time. A verb indicates the time of an action, event or condition by changing its form. As I explained you that a verb indicates a time of an action, event or condition by changing its form. And this word tense is derived from Latin word tempus, which means time. So how you can get the idea of change in time? By changing the form of the verbs. Let's have some more example. As here, Ram reads. So it means here we have used first form of the verb. So it became present tense. Here, take the second example. Ram read. So it is telling about the past action. Third example, Ram will read. It is telling about the future action. In all three examples, only whose form is changing? Verbs forms are changing. Here we have used verb first form with is. Here we have used second form of the verb, which means past tense. And here we have used first form of the verb with will. So I hope now it's clear to you what is tense. Tense is time. A verb indicates time of an action, event or condition by changing its forms. Now let's understand the form. So now let's start with the understanding of forms of the verbs. As I told you, the change of forms of verbs will give you effect of change in time. So basically there are three forms of verb about which you are getting in your books, but we use two more form of the verbs. Now let's understand all five form of the verbs. First form of the verb, just take example of do. Do is telling about the action. So first form of the verb of do will be do, which we use in present tense and in future tense. What is the difference between the both? How you will get the difference? That I will tell you in detail in later. First you understand which form of the verb we are using in which tense. First form of the verb we are using in present and in future. Second form of the verb, for example, did. So second form of the verb do became did, which we use in past tense. Only and only past tense. Third form of the verb is done. That is called past participle, which we use in perfect tense. I will explain you further. And fourth form of the verb, which we are making by adding ing into the base form of the verb or first form of the verb. See the example, I add ing into do. So by adding ing, do became doing, which we are using in continuous tense. Fifth form of the verbs that we find by adding s or es into the base form of the verb or first form of the verbs. As I have done here, I have added es into do, so it became does. It is also used in present tense, but with singular subjects only. As I told you, first form of the verb is also used in present tense, and fifth form of the verb is also used in present tense. So what is the difference between both? Let's understand the difference between both. Difference lies in numbers. With singular number, we use fifth form of the verb, and with plural number, we use first form of the verb in present tense. For example, he goes. If subject in a singular, then we use fifth form of the verb. Ram does. If subject is plural, then we use only first form of the verb for writing a present tense. They go. Students go. I hope it's clear to you that in present tense we use first form of the verb with plural subject and fifth form of the verb with singular subject. Now let's understand how we form this fifth form of the verbs. Let's understand how we can find fifth form of the verb which we use in a simple present tense with singular subjects. For example, with most of verbs add s. It means with most of verbs we add only s. For example, live became lives, sit became sits, stay became stays. As here we have added only, I have added only s. Now see the second condition, ending in consonant plus y, change y to I and add es. If any verb end with y followed by consonant, then y change into I and add es. Let's see example how. Try. In this verb end with y followed by a consonant r. So what we are going to do, how we are going to change into fifth form of the verb? By changing y into I and added es. So try became tries. For example, carry. So in this verb, carry end with y followed by a consonant. So what we will do, we will change y into I and add es. So carry became carries. In this way, we add es into this verb which end with y followed by consonant. Let's see the another condition. Ending in s, z, ch or x, add es. Those verbs end with these letters, then add only es. For example, miss became misses, buzz became buzzes, catch is ending with ch, it became catches, fix, it is ending with x, so it became fixes. And there are some exceptional cases for those what we are doing. For example, go. In go, we will add es. So go became goes. Do, we will add es. So do became does. I hope you understood how to find fifth form of the verb which we use with singular subject. After understanding the forms of verbs, let's understand the types of tenses. Tenses are divided on the basis of type into three types: present, past and future. Let's see the definition. Based on the time frame, the verb tenses may be categorized according to the time frame. First, present tense, past tense, future tense.
Let's understand what is present tense. Present tense expresses an unchanging, repeated or recurring action or situation that exists not only now. It can also represent a widespread truth. It means whatever is happening in present, that is called present tense. For example, Ram eats an apple. Next, past tense. Past tense expresses an action or situation that was started and finished in the past. It means whatever has already completed or done, that is called past tense. For example, Ram ate an apple. Next, third, future tense. Future tense expresses an action or situation that will occur in the future. It means anything yet to be done. For example, Ram will eat an apple. Tense is further divided into four parts on the nature of the action. Let's understand. Based on aspect, verb tenses may also be categorized according to aspect. What is aspect? Aspect refers to the nature of the action described by the verb. There are four aspects. First, indefinite or simple. Second, continuous or progressive. Third, perfect or complete. Fourth, perfect continuous. Let's understand each separately. First, indefinite tense. The three indefinite tenses or simple tenses describe an action but do not state whether the action is finished. It means it defines certainty is not there. Second, continuous tense. The three continuous tenses, incomplete tenses or progressive tenses describe an unfinished action. It means it is telling the action is going on, the work is going on. Third, perfect tense. The three complete tenses or perfect tenses describe a finished action. It means something has just completed and completed in certain time. Fourth, for perfect continuous tense. To combine the complete tenses and the incomplete tenses to describe an action which was in progress and then finished. It means something has started in past, as still continue in present and will be continue in future. There are 12 possible verb tenses. As I told you, tenses divided into three parts: present, past and future. And they further divided into four parts each: present indefinite, present continuous, present perfect, present perfect continuous. Same with past. Past is also further divided into four parts on the nature of action: past indefinite, past continuous, past perfect continuous. Let's understand future. Future is also further divided into four parts on the nature of action: future indefinite, future continuous, future perfect continuous. That's it for today. In our next class, I will start with present tense. But before to end this class, I want that all of you have to learn and write at least 20 forms of the verbs with the help of your grammar book if you have, or with the help of Google. As I told you, forms of the verbs are very important to write correct sentence in correct tense.